does, so we can keep the curb. His brother, that's great, so we can.
Riding somebody with a tractor.
You can ask it.
Do that.
It's hard, you can't.
Well, I know one person I know. I think my grass got a job.
Thank you. It's good to see all of you on this rainy morning, the third Sunday in Lent. Believe it or not, in 3 weeks, we will be at Palm Sunday, 4 weeks Easter Sunday. Time is moving quickly, and we are enjoying the season of Lent as we gather together and worship together. And this morning, I'm looking forward to worshiping together and to drawing closer to God as a family of God. A few announcements, though, that we need to make. There's three that come to my mind immediately. One, there is a session meeting tomorrow at 6 o'clock. Bible study Tuesday evening at 6 o'clock. We meet right across the hall in the lounge upstairs here. And the information about that study is in your room. All are welcome to come and join us. And Wednesday evening, we have a music and worship committee. So that is at 6 o'clock also. Then, as I look on our announcements and our deacons are updating our church directory, those forms are out in Martex. If you could just fill those out, and we could use those to create a new directory. Oh, we are excited about the Easter Bunny brunch. Or is that bunch or brunch?
Brunch.
Brunch. And it will be a bunch here also. That is Saturday, April 2nd, which is less than 2 weeks away. So make your reservations with Cheryl sitting down here in front. It's going to be lots of good food. Pancakes, sausage,
waffles,
yogurt, plus lots of fun for the kids. Lots of good food for the adults, lots of fun for the kids. Don't want to miss that. Sunday school meeting after church next Sunday. We're going to Sunday school teachers and staff will meet this year as they're continuing to plan things for our kids. Easter flower forms also in the narthex. If you'd like to purchase a flower for Easter Sunday in memory of someone, make sure you fill out the form and get that form in the city. Anything else? Any other announcement I'm missing this morning? Anything else happening? All right. If not, then we're ready for our Lenten reading. Pilate's Judgment Gavel.
Our Lenten reading for today is titled Pilate's Judgment Gavel, and we will look by going into the book of John, chapter 18, verses 28 through 40. Then the Jewish leaders took Jesus from Caiaphas to the place of the Roman governor. By now it was early morning, and to avoid ceremonial uncleanliness, they did not enter the palace, because they wanted to be able to eat the Passover. So Pilate came out to them and asked, "What charges are you bringing against this man?" "If you were not a criminal," they replied, "we would not have handed him over to you." Pilate said, "Take him yourself and judge him by your own law." "But we have no right to execute anyone," they objected. This took place to fulfill what Jesus had said about the kind of death he was going to die. Pilate then went back inside the palace, summoned Jesus, and asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" "Is that your own idea?" Jesus asked. "Or did others talk to you about me?" "Am I a Jew?" Pilate replied. "Your own people and chief priests handed you over to me. What is it you have done?" Jesus said, "My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight to prevent my arrest by the Jewish leaders. But now, my kingdom is from another place." "You are a king then," said Pilate. Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. In fact, the reason I was born and came into the world is to testify to the truth. Everyone on the side of truth listens to me. What is truth? Retorted Pilate. With this he went out again to the Jews gathered there and said, I find no bias for charge against him, but it is your custom for me to release to you one prisoner at the time of the Passover. Do you want me to release the King of the Jews? They shouted back, No, not him. Give us Barabbas. Now Barabbas had taken part in an uprising. So Pilate's judgment gathered is a symbol of the world's lack of justice. When confronted with the truth of God, Pilate caved to the will of man. His lack of backbone sent an innocent man, the very Son of God, to agonizing death on the cross. We must face that same decision Pilate faced. Now, what will we do with this Jesus who claims to be a king of a kingdom not of this world? Do we cave secular world's judgment? Or do we bow before him and become a follower and citizen of God's kingdom?
Next, we are going to have our one great hour of sharing. Jay, are you doing that this morning?
As members of Coleraine Presbyterian Church, you can participate in the One Great Hour sharing by donating. For the next few weeks, a special envelope will be included in the bulletin. And today we have another option. We have fish coin banks. If the children would come forward, they can help distribute the coin banks to anybody who would like one.
If you'd like one, maybe put your hand up and the kids can bring you a coin box.
I have led for the Lord.
ready for our children's sermon. Kids, I'd like you to come down front, sit in this row in front of Cheryl so that you can see the slides.
Thank you. by God's grace through the Son that we can be restored and renewed. Please join me in the prayer of confession. We confess to you, O God, and before one another that we have sinned. We have been unfaithful to you and hurtful to one another. We have said we are sorry when we have no intention of changing. We have said we are sorry when we intended to change, but have not changed. We are more interested in people thinking we are good than we are in actually being good. Forgive us and make us bold to turn our lives around and live fully in your presence. Amen. Please take a moment for your own personal prayer of confession. Amen.
Since God has forgiven us in Christ, let us forgive one another. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Let's take a moment and pass the peace of Christ to one another. Shake each other's hand and say good morning.
Good morning,
Renton. Good morning. Jackson to you and Tom. Be with them, Lord, in all that they're going through. Watch over Susie. We think of Denny and Tammy. Be with Sally and Kathy. We lift up Gail to you and Jean. Lord, some of these people are going through treatments right now. Others are on meds. We pray, Lord, that those medications would be effective, those treatments would be effective. Continue to be with Sharon and Ron. We think of John, Tom. We lift up Jack to you and Marlene. We think of Donna and young Leo. Be with Karen. Again, Lord, we pray you be with all these people in this battle, with a difficult battle they're facing. Watch over them and their families. Lord, we want to lift up others to you. We think of young Sophia and young Colton, both battling diabetes. Be with them. Be with all of our young ones. We thank you for the growth of this youth program here at the church. Continue to bless this program and their teachers. Watch over these others with health problems. We lift up Ron to you and Lisa. We think of Donna and Libby's mom, Greta. Watch over Peggy. Watch over Nancy. Young Luca and this heart problem he has. Shirley Bedline, Carly Fairbanks, we lift up to you. We think of Randy and Peggy and their health problems. Watch over Sue and Bill. Be with Edna, our friend Bill. We think of Don Thompson and Doris Morrison. Watch over their lives. Be with Patrick's dad, Mr. McCormick, and the neck problem and the hip problem. Continue to be with Marie, recovering from her stroke. We continue to lift up Dave and Dana to you. Taylor and God's calling upon his life. We think of Ryan and Jack. Watch over them. Be with Dorothy and Celeste. We think of Bill battling Parkinson's, our friend Jane and her health problems. Watch over Barbara and her hip problem. Scott and Diana, we lift up to you. We think of Bruce and Amy, my brother-in-law Jim, we lift up to you. Be with Carolyn and Lisa. Be with Betty and Scott. We lift up Ron, who was having a heart problem, and Gunn, who's facing seizures. Be with Shana and her health. Leanne's husband, who just had a stroke. Ryan, recovering from surgery. Bill, with blood clot problems. Joe Matthew with internal bleeding, and Joe Thompson, his heart problem. So Lord, we lift them all up to you, and we pray that you would work in their lives. Is there anything each of us need to do, whether it be call or send a card or say hello? We pray, Lord, that we would listen to your spirit and do whatever you call us to do. Lord, now we pray for this world and all that it's going through. We don't know what's going to happen, but we pray for peace. We ask, Lord, that you would intervene through the leaders of this world, and that there would be a path of peace that could be found. We pray for those in this world who are putting their lives on the line for us, our military people. Watch over them and their families. And Lord, we pray for those who are trying to share the love and the mercy and grace of our Lord Jesus Christ with others. Watch over them. And now we're going to sing together the Lord's Prayer. tithes, our gifts, and our offerings. Our New Testament reading this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 13, verses 1 through 5. Hear the word of God. Now there were some present at that time who told Jesus about the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mixed with their sacrifices. Jesus answered, Do you think that these Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans because they suffered this way? I tell you, no. But unless you repent, you too will all perish. For those 18 who died when the tower in Siloam fell on them, do you think they were more guilty than all the others living in Jerusalem? I tell you, no. But unless you repent, you too will all perish. May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of this holy word. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for these words from the book of Exodus as you spoke to Moses, and these words of Jesus to the people that he was preaching to. We ask for understanding because sometimes your word is deep and we need to dig into it and gain a deeper understanding of what it means so that it can have an impact on our lives. So we pray that your spirit would be our teacher this morning and reveal the depths of your word to us. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. All down through the centuries, people have asked the same question again and again. Who are you, God? Who are you? I tell you what, I like the answer that God gave to Moses there in the book of Exodus chapter 3. We know that Moses climbed to the top of Mount Horeb as he tended his father-in-law's flocks. And there he saw a burning bush that was burning yet was not being consumed. And he drew near to that burning bush. Throughout scriptures, fire has been a symbol of God's presence. The best example of the New Testament, of course, is the tongues of fire that came down on Pentecost Sunday. So Moses drew near to that bush and he had an encounter with God. And God instructed him that he was to confront the Pharaoh and demand that the Israelites be set free. And this is how Moses responded. Moses said to God, "Suppose I go to the Israelites and say to them, 'The God of your fathers has sent me to you,' and they ask me, 'What is his name?' Then what shall I tell them?" God said to Moses, "I am who I am. This is what you are saying to the Israelites. I am has sent me to you." Now, when a person hears that answer, God's name is I am. What does that mean? In other words, God is saying, "I exist. I am truly the creator of all things. I am, and because I am, you have the opportunity to discover who I am." In other words, God invites us on a journey of discovery in this relationship. And that answer that God gave, "I am," is not an all-encompassing answer. It doesn't cover all the bases. It's more like an invitation. You are going to discover who I am step by step. Along this spiritual path, along this journey, you must take that first step of faith in this journey of discovery. Now, that path of discovery that God calls us upon became much, much brighter when Jesus arrived on this earth. Why is that? Well, when we say that Jesus it is God in the form of a human being, what do we really mean by that? We mean that from birth, the Spirit of God came through the Lord Jesus, and all the words that God wanted to say came through Jesus, and he spoke them forth to the people. All the teachings that Jesus gave came from the Spirit of God, through him, to the people. All the acts that Jesus did, the healing, the helping, all the good things that Jesus did throughout his life that we witness in the New Testament came from God's power, God's Spirit through him to us. In other words, through the Son, God set the example of who God is. We can listen to Jesus' words. We can watch his acts or read his acts in the Bible, and we get a reflection of who God is. The Apostle Paul said it this way. Colossians 1, verse 15. Paul said, the Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. And so by knowing and understanding the life of Jesus, we get to know the great I Am, God Almighty. And in my journey of faith, as I have traveled along this road of knowing and studying Jesus' life and words and acts, and in so doing, discovering who God is, I've also